Welcome back to Let's Play The Outer Worlds Blind. I just want to quickly check something. I want to see if there's... I think there's a vending machine in here. I need some more heavy ammo. And light couldn't hurt either. There is. I think I'm going to buy ammo, or at least these two, whenever I come across them. Because I have a lot of money, and I don't have a lot of ammo. That's a little better. So yeah, there it is. Okay. And then I know there's one at the landing pad. There's at least one. I think there's two. Too, right? Doing better. Yeah, yeah, spacious joys. Now, I'm assuming these, like, replenish after a while. That one has a different song. Wait, there's more over here. This one's board approved. Apparently I can go in there. Is that a good idea, though?
Not a peep for me. Nicely done.
How much ammo do I have now? Oh, plenty. Oop. If we even spotted in here, probably wouldn't be good. Turn around and come back this way? Are you going around? You're going around.
That was quick.
Hmm. I got those over there. And then he goes that way. Hit those two and I'll just leave. There might be some stuff ducked back there, but I can't be jumping around with him like that, can I? Maybe. I don't even see what I got. I just grabbed it so quick. See what's in that corner. Wait, there's more stuff here. A ring. A couple energy cells, not much at all. Oh, wait. Nothing? I don't think there's anything back there, actually. It's all dark. Once he starts moving that way, I'm just gonna walk out. Cool. I think we have enough ammo. And we have that much. Back to the power plant, and then we'll go try to find this book, this illustrated manual, whatever. And then we have two more bounties to fulfill. It's not far. Cave entrance right there, huh? Marauder Vandal. That was easy compared to some of the other battles we've encountered lately. So they were not far from this, where that researcher or assistant. Was These guys didn't even have guns, some of them. Most of them. Transport wreckage. Cool. I mean, even if there's not quests, you can just, like, wander around and find all this stuff. Can I even get in here? I don't think I can. No, that's not a thing. It's just wreckage. And they decided to make some camp around it. I don't know, maybe they wanted to break into the place. Quest updated. You found an entrance to the river cave mentioned in the collector's note. The book must lie somewhere within. Think crouching in water would help you drown more effectively. The book is indeed quite close. And there are two enemy things quite close as well. Three, actually. What is that? Is that like a mine or something? There's another one there. I think they are mines. Who would be guarding this book? River hideout discovered. There's someone hiding back there. Some ones. I wonder what lay further in that direction as well. I'd say blow up this mine, which would attract them. Maybe they'll trip off the other mines. Maybe not. They're moving. Oh, the book's right there. You okay? I figured we could get a little close to it. Let's have some bread. Use. They're beyond all this? Journal of M. Bakonu. Whatever it is not in here, actually. Two magpicks. I mean, they might run up in here, I don't know. They're that way. Got me, man. Doesn't look like I can get in there.
Okay, gone quiet.
That's the way we came in, so what's out there? I don't know. Let's go this way. I know I wasted that bread, but I have a lot more. Let me take a look at this. A handwritten journal with the name M. Bakonu scrawled in the lower corner. Indeed. Oh, it's Doc Mabel's finger. Hmm. Also, what did the notes say? You found the Journal of M. Bakonu. Return to the Vicar. You see, a thing I don't like is he wants to destroy this book. Apparently. We come out the other side with a lot of baddies. They're on top. They're up there. That's what I was seeing. Beasties? Primal Hunter. Those are tough. I remember them killing me back in the beginning, but then that was the beginning. Oh, that. Oh. That looks really scary. Oh boy. Oh, there's too many. That one's dead? Am I stuck in prime time or something? Oh boy. Oh, I'm dead. Oh, that was me being in damaged mode. It's kind of what it looked like, only it didn't hold a weapon.
Hands down.
And it didn't have a helmet. That uses it. Which is the one that gives you more armor, this one.
Here they come. Can't get past that armor. Armor's too strong. Hit it with something else.
Oh boy.
That's the last of them.
Wow. Spacer's Choice found a flaw in you. Flaw tutorial. During your adventures, things may happen to your character that can trigger a flaw offer. Taking a flaw is optional, but doing so provides you with a perk. The choice is yours. Drug addiction. Great. Taking as many drugs as you have has turned to an addiction, making you suffer withdrawal if you go too long without another hit. Reward is one perk point. I'm gonna reject it. I don't know if that's a good idea. Wow. Okay. Where are we now? We're right by Edgewater. Primal Hide. This recently harvested primal hive is still wet and covered in skin parasites. Properly processed at a leather facility, it can be made into a nice pair of shoes or perhaps a jacket. Or we just slaughter these guys. Primal Hunter, Ravager, Behemoth. What'd you do? Loot all these things? I don't think she does. Does an in-character thing. That's pretty brutal.
I used to skip rocks in the river till Constable Reyes ticketed me for unlicensed terraforming. I think she's jealous. She don't know how to skip rocks her own self. Where are we headed?
I guess you might have more to say. I don't know where we would. Where was the we just ran. I wasn't like paying attention. Was it up here? Up the river? It had to be. Yeah, they were over here. I know I'm not finding them all. Here's a little one. Primal Brain. This brain is not missing any parts. This could be worth a lot of bits to a brain collector. Good luck finding one. Yeah, most of them ran down here. Oh man, that was rather chaotic. I think one of them got stuck on a rock or something. Otherwise, we might not have survived. Alright, let's return with this manual. I know we're right here, but... We came in this way, though. OSI is this way?
If you're falling sick, I don't want you here.
Wonder if the plague's ever gonna stop.
We're looking for OSI. Hello.
It's a fine new day in Edgewater. The cannery hums, streetlights and faces glow. I suppose this means the two of you were able to sort out the matter?
And the deserters are moving back, even Adelaide.
I am somewhat taken aback by that, given the heat between her and Mr. Thompson. What deal did you strike with her, I wonder?
Well, I found Adelaide's been digging up corpses to improve the soil.
From our own graveyard, just outside the gates. And Silas had not even an inkling. What do they pay the man for?
He spends all day digging graves, Vicar. Sir. Sometimes he's got to sleep.
Yes, of course. My reaction was unreasonable.
Yeah, I don't want to cause trouble. Is what she told me true? That the soil's sour and you can't raise crops?
Flowers grow well enough, and creeping ivies, and the fuzzies that grow on rocks, but we don't eat none of that.
It is my understanding that none of the local life, plant or animal, is edible. Earth crops are grown in farms, not isolated cannery towns. Once the spark of life has fled, the mortal form is but unanimated matter, comprised of the same elements as the rest of the universe. We inter for the comfort of the living, not the benefit of the dead. While distasteful, I would judge Ms. McDevitt's actions beneficial to the greater good.
Well, some might be a bit upset at their dead friends or relatives being used as fertilizer.
Then I would counsel them to work through their emotions and assess the matter rationally. Animals are ruled by their hearts. Humans were gifted with intellect for a purpose.
Now you got a point there. I've got your book.
Wonderful. This is fantastic. Well worth all the sacrifices I... Wait. What the fuck is this? Is this French? I can't fucking read French. It's a law-forsaken joke is what it is. French! Ha! I was so high and mighty, preaching to the yokels about following the plan, while fighting it at every turn.
Nice bits. I can't believe he said it like that. This is not your ordinary vicar. You didn't want to keep that book for... You didn't want that book to keep others from reading it. You just wanted it for yourself.
Well, yes. But I assure you, it was not for personal gain, only for the greater good. I've spent my life searching for the keys to unlocking the secrets of the universal equation that underlies the plan. I had hoped this book held some of those answers. I became so desperate, I even got myself assigned to this plague-ridden backwater to find the damn thing. All the time and suffering I've spent. Wasted.
Why did you think the book held the secrets you were looking for?
Bokonu, the author, had some interesting theories about man's perception of reality that I thought could be applied to our attempts to decipher the plan. Unfortunately, he was also one of the founders of the philosophist school of thought, so the book is banned in this colony.
What's a philosophist?
Philosophism's a false religion that stands in contradiction to almost everything we know to be true. They believe all is chaos, in stark contrast to OSI's belief in the plan. But most of the philosophist perversion of Bokonu's thoughts came more than a century after his death.
At least you still have your mission work here to give your life a meaningful purpose.
Please. As if my life should have no greater meaning than proselytizing to a bunch of feeble-minded wretches. Nothing could be more excruciating than discussing the true nature of reality with people who have no interest beyond their next Aetherwave program. But that's neither here nor there. What I need to do now is to find a translator, obviously. But to do that, I'll first need to secure transport. You have a ship. Perhaps I could make myself of use to your crew.
Huh. What's in it for me?
Free spiritual counseling, someone to watch your back, not to mention a grown-up in the party.
A grown-up?
I'm 28.
Exactly. I'm pretty handy with a tossball stick, or any blunt instrument, really. I'm also a passable gun hand, if it comes to that. I can usually talk my way out of conflict, though. Oh. I'm fairly competent at hacking computers as well.
So then, if I have it right, I think his, like, conversation skills, like persuasion, intimidation, will increase ours, and his hacking will increase ours. Is that all part of your Vicar training?
Well, understanding computers is, though I admit I took it further than most. And I was quite the 32nd back during my seminary days. Left many an opponent bleeding on the field.
Are you even a vicar? Because you aren't sounding very vicarly right now.
Of course. I'm a vicar who is dedicated to his calling. More dedicated than any other you'll find in this colony. I joined the OSI to help decipher the grand plan. But instead, I ended up the vicar in a prison due to ignorance and politics. Then I came here. Satisfied?
Almost. How'd you get assigned to prison duty?
Most laypeople are not aware of this, but we've not discovered any new insights into the plan for a long, long time. I had an idea that we should welcome the truth, no matter where we found it. I had the worse idea to share my thoughts with a superior. And that's the long and short of it. So, what do you think?
Sounds good. Let's go.
Fantastic. I promise you won't regret this.
Hope not.
Edgewater's gonna miss you. Folk here always had good things to say about their vicar.
Thank you, Ms. Holcomb. I'll be glad for the change of scenery. And to leave this place behind. It is my esteemed pleasure to serve as your crew vicar, Captain.
I had no idea